A two-spot ladybird awakens. She spent the winter hibernating in the shed. Now that warmth has returned to the garden, the race is on to breed. Hungry and dehydrated, her first task is to find food. In the rose bushes, a wasteland of discarded aphid skins sets her on the right path. These are the clues she was looking for. Nearby, an aphid colony. This little lady hasn't eaten in months, and she immediately gets stuck into the banquet. She'll eat up to 60 aphids a day. Little wonder gardeners love them. Our female isn't the only two-spot at large in the garden. Males are also on the hunt, and they're not looking for food. It's love they're after. Encounters are a random affair, but there's no time for tender caresses. Individuals literally bump into each other and get going, and going, and going. Female ladybirds are highly promiscuous, so when a male gets his girl, it pays to hang on to her. The pair will mate for up to 8 hours. Not long after this mating marathon, she lays clutches of eggs. Over the spring, she'll lay 1,000 eggs, and timing is key. She needs her young to take advantage of the seasonal glut of prey. Depending on the weather, the eggs take up to 5 days to hatch. They darken as the developing embryos grow. And finally, they're ready. Emerging head first, the larvae pump up their blood pressure to free themselves from their shells. As soon as they're out, these miniature eating machines set off on their path of destruction. First, they eat the egg from which they've hatched and any that haven't developed. Then, they turn their attention to their brothers and sisters. Sibling cannibalism is rife in two spots, so it pays to hatch first. There's nothing like a quick entree before the main course, which is, of course, juicy, honey-filled aphids. The sole purpose of these larvae is to grow. And grow. And grow. And when it's molted 3 times, this little beast is ready to make its penultimate transformation. Emerging from the final larval stage, a pupa. Soft at first, over the next few hours, the outer layer hardens into a solid pupal casing. After a few days, signs of life are visible. and what climbs out is opalescent and beautiful. A dewy, fresh, monochrome ladybird is born. Immediately after birth, she's soft-bodied and vulnerable. But over the next few hours, she'll harden and her bright colours and spots will develop. By autumn, her own offspring will be adult ladybirds. They'll overwinter back in the shed and emerge next spring, ready to continue the cycle all over again.
It really is fascinating to see such a familiar species in such detail. It reminds us not to take ladybirds for granted. And in fact, we mustn't take the two-spot ladybird for granted because it's in real trouble. It's declined 44% in the last 10 years. And that's largely due to the invasive Harlequin ladybird, which looks like this. Quite difficult to spot because there's so much colour variation, and all these photographs have been sent in by viewers on our Flickr photographs. But these are the ones that you're more likely to see in your houses, in warm little corners under the stairs and maybe by the windows. And they are voracious predators of the two spots. And they have spread dramatically over the UK. How do we know this? Well, it's because the public have told us through citizen science and a ladybird survey, which is ongoing. So please let us know everything that you find out about ladybirds, whether they're in your house, outside, what they're doing, what species they are. If you don't know, take a photograph, and what their location is, and send that into the website. All the details of that survey are on the website. That's bbc.co.uk/springwatch. And they'll be talking more about ladybirds on Unsprung, which will start straight after we've finished at 9 o'clock on the red button and online as well with Nick Baker.